better hit that subscribe button.
And at YouTube, I'm Freddy Quogo, play Manhattan Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. Going to be showing you something. This is on my Elgato Game Capture HD app. See where it says HDMI, device other, 1080, expanded color, blah, blah, blah. This is how I record my PS3 through HDMI, and I'm going to show you the trick of the trade that I use. I found another two other ways to do it, and right here you have the monoprice converter, and it does DVI, that's the cable right there, and then I have the audio pumping out through the optical cable. And as you see right there, blue rugger, and it runs over here into here. The optical cable goes in here, it's optical in, then it actually has the optical out, so you can listen to audio pass through, say, to your surround sound, which I have mine set up via. So I put it on two channel on the PS3. And go right here. Alright. I go to audio settings. And I put it on. Oh no, audio settings. Here it goes, audio settings. And I put it on audio multi out. So it goes through my through both of them. Then I put it on optical, uncheck Dolby 5.1 because it only does two channel. There are some devices that actually do and make sure that this is on, so you can have audio to both devices. So if you want to use your TV for audio, or you want to go through the other device. Now what it does is HDCP encryption only goes through HDMI, so when you pass your audio through your optical cable and have a DVI to HDMI converter like this, it just bypasses it. Then this box right here reconverts it into a pure HDMI signal without no HDCP. Then it runs out into your, you know, your Hub Hog, your Elgato, your Avermedia Gamer Capture Portable, your, you know what I'm saying, whatever, your Roxio, and then it pumps back out via the HDMI, and the signal's caught back from here, and goes there. And is there any lag or anything like that? Not that I can tell. I play seamlessly, and there's no video lag. The only time you get lag is from what you're capturing. It's like a two second delay on what you're capturing. It's not done in real time. So then when I'm recording in here, I'm recording at, and this depends on your software and your device, 30 megabytes a second. Bam, preserve the format. And that's basically, and it takes about 1 second or two to three seconds to register. And that's via HDMI signal, where it looks very crisp. The colors pop. The audio is good. It's all digital signal. And you don't have to worry about component cables. And this works with any Blu-ray player, whether it be, you know, your PC, your, you know what I'm saying, the same thing. It'll work with any of them. For PC capturing, for your Blu-ray to rip your videos for your Blu-ray, and certain captures devices like the Avermedia Game Capture Portable actually does 60 megabytes a second, so that's good. 1080p, 30 frames, 720p, 60 frames. It doesn't record at 24 frames, which is how movies are recorded. And what you need is this. I'm going to leave the other devices that I know that actually either strip or bypass the HDCP encryption. And that's how I record my PS3. That's my PS3 with the Vault Battlefield 3 Vault case on there. And then when I don't want it, when I'm not recording, I just take this, change the input for my TV, and just play like that. Bam. And that's how I do it. I have my, when I do game commentaries, just go in here, and where it says audio, well, it actually has a live commentary button right there. Bam. And I just put my Astros in there. And these are the headsets I wear, the Astro A40s. And this mic is being picked up. And then when I want to do game chat, I put the, this is trade secrets, but you know, it's something that I do. See, I'll just change this to say wireless headset, right? And put the output device to default. And then I will use my, where's my Bluetooth at? Well, I have it around here. I have a PS3 Bluetooth, and I use that, and I just hang it right here on my shirt. Then have the headphones on, the sound to go through the headset, and then the mic on the headset is going for the game capturing, and I don't have to use some like snowball or anything, any type of mic. I do have those type of mics, so it ain't that I don't have it, and I do have other ways to get around, you know, audio doing, capturing, you know, your voice, live commentary. I used to use that when I used to use the analog with the component cables. But now that I went all digital, basically it's, this right here, this Ouya is going to get replaced by a PlayStation Vita TV when it comes out. And, yeah, for remote play, for those of y'all don't know, hold on, let's do remote play. Bam. Registered devices, list. Okay, that's my registered device. This is how you could turn on your PS3. And via remote play on your device. Now I'm going to turn off my PS3. And I have remote play. Alright, I'm going to turn off the PS3 right here. Alright. And turn on my Vita. And this is what's going to make fucking that Vita TV so badass to, you know, you could take that Vita TV wherever you want. And then you go to your friend's house and it's like having an extra PlayStation 4. All right, where's remote play? Remote play. I'm going to go via the internet. And watch it turn on. There it goes, it just turned on. It's on. You're gonna see it do like flicker over here to catch the signal. It's pumping through the signal. It's on here. Now it's just gonna say remote play up here. And this is why remote play was the main feature why I bought this damn PlayStation Vita. See now it says remote play? Bam. Y'all just seen which theme I had on here. And now I have all this to work with. And if this was the PlayStation 4, I'd be playing the PlayStation 4. And this is not through the through me connecting it directly to there. This is through the internet. And it is lag free. What Remote Play, just like any cloud gaming service, does, it's cloud gaming. Basically, that's the cloud. Your PlayStation 3, your PlayStation 4 is the cloud. And then this is called your node terminal. And your node is, this is basically being, this is slave. So it's in slave mode, and it's running, and I could just go here, and there ain't no games that work remote play very good. Let's see. Nope, see? Doesn't work. Let's see. Nope. Nope. DuckTales, maybe? Nope. Star Wars? Nope. Diablo 3? Nope. So, but in general, see, like this, I could actually, boom. Killzone Shadowfall, or Killzone Mercenary. This would be Killzone Shadowfall. Then you press the thing. Oh no, this is when you press the thing, it has the PlayStation button, the power button. Now, turn off system, you see? And now my PlayStation is going to turn off. Oh yeah, I have to actually hit yes. Okay. And now you can turn it off. And then I'm going to turn it back on via... And there it goes. It's turning back on. So, remote play is very something that's going to be used right with the PlayStation 4, I believe, and the Vita products, the Vita TV, which is its own standalone. Basically, it is this, but without the screen, without the controller. It's just the components that make it, and then it has an I/O, which are the, you know, this is I/O, that the headphone jack, the cartridge for the memory and all that stuff. And it has a new 1 gig of RAM, and this only has 512 right now. The new version of the Vita has 1 gig of RAM as well, but they have the same 512 graphics card, ARM, quad-core ARM graphics card. Anyways, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to do this video to show people there is a way around everything, and it's not very expensive. This actually cost you about $34. The other device is a HDMI splitter, and I will find the link and put it in there as well. You can buy them from Amazon. I will leave the links for the purchases of those devices if you are interested in that, to record things in HDMI that, you know, they have that type of HDCP encryption. Whether you're trying to make your physical copy of your games or movies or whatever into digital copies via gameplay, or just ripping your DVD, your Blu-rays or DVDs or anything and turning them into digital copies. Not saying to pirate them. I am saying if you own a copy of something and you're trying to make it a digital copy, you are legally, you can do that. If you have a copy digitally made of, say, Pirates of the Caribbean 2, and you go in your house and you have a Blu-ray disc of Pirates of the Caribbean 2 like I do, then you're covered legally. Anyways, that's it, man. If you like the video, thumb it up. Just been having made a video. I wanted to make a video earlier, but I started playing Diablo 3 with the wife, and that game just sucks away your life. Anyways, man, that's it. Peace. Remember to go hit the like button if you like the video, dislike the video. Tell me in the comment section what I did wrong or what your opinion is on any of this. If you're mad, Sony, everything Sony has said about sharing gameplay and stuff like that has been consistent. There's somebody said that it was a credible, not want to be disclosed person saying that they're not going to let you do it, when the chief architect said on Jimmy Kimmel Live, I believe it was, or Jimmy Fallon Live, or one of them late night shows, that you're going to be able to, you know, upload directly to YouTube from the PlayStation 4. And they said it, like, that's been their resounding voice of what they've said. So I'm not giving any credibility towards what this person is saying, because he doesn't want to be named, nor is it credible because of the fact that you don't want to be named, or when the opposition says, you know, they've actually said that. But if they're stupid enough to do this, and Sony is stupid enough to go about doing this, at least let us record gameplay. I don't give a fuck about the movie part. If you have that encryption during the movie part, that's just easy. It's easy to tell a movie from a fucking game, because they run at different frame rates and different hertz. Games run at 60 hertz, and Blu-ray discs usually run at 24 hertz. So it's very easy to get, you know what I'm saying, to bypass it. If Microsoft and Xbox could do it, then you should be able to do it as well, Sony. So don't let your competitors make you look like assholes to the gaming community, because I will call your bitch asses out on it in a fucking heartbeat, you faggots. So don't even try doing this shit to us, because we will fuck you over in the wallet where it counts. You can follow me on Twitter at Freddy Flame. All the links and all that shit will be in the description, so go check out the description. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters, keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming. Remote play is just waiting for his companion Vita TV. Well, that's what the PlayStation 4 is waiting for, but that's my shit, though. That's why I bought the Vita, was for remote play, and the PS4 is going to bring that into fruition completely. Please.
Thumb up the video, fool!